Hi FooX, my name is Lynn. I'm a football player from Germany and the current world champion in women's doubles. Welcome to another episode of Strategy Sunday with Linja. In my other videos, I already talked about shooting strategies, like conditioning, timing, or shooting on pictures and stuff like that. But the question how I actually look at the defense reached out to me very often. So today it's all about this question and I try to answer it. If you're interested in buying a Leonard table, make sure to visit the Leonard page. And with my code LINHJAGER International, you can get 5% discount on your table you're choosing. And also a very cool package with 10 official Leo balls and also 8 reps from Leo Slam. I will compare two different ways of how to look at a defense. What I'm talking about is indirect and direct read. What do I mean by that and what are the differences between them? When you're looking at defense in an indirect way, it means, for example, you don't look at the goal specifically. So you are not watching specifically at the puppets in an isolated way. It is more like you would look at the ball and have a peripheral look and read to the defense. That means you see the defense as a whole defense, so like a one defense. You don't separate the movements, you don't isolate them or anything like that. So the advantage of this way of reading is that you see the whole, right? So you have kind of an overview of the whole defense, but the disadvantage could be that you miss details. So it might be that you are not scoring and then you want to think about the defense, but you cannot really remember what specifically one puppet did. So you can imagine the direct reading is kind of the opposite of the indirect reading. That means you are looking specifically at one area of the goal, or it could also be a specific puppet, only looking at the goalie man or only looking at the two row. So it could be different things which you are isolating, right? So the advantages of reading in a direct way is that you can remember very good on the details of specific movements which you were concentrated on. The disadvantage, of course, is that you cannot really say something about the whole defense. It could be, for example, that you missed that the other puppet is coming in. So kind of stuff like that is a little bit difficult when you're just specifically focusing on one area. But just because I described two different ways, it doesn't mean that you cannot mix it up a little bit. So you could, for example, take your time in the first 5 seconds and look in an indirect way. And after you get an overview about the defense, you can go into the direct reading and focus on a specific area. I will give you two examples which you can use for both ways. Example number one, shooting around the two-bar man. That means you really focus on the two-bar man where he actually moves. If your opponent is not crossing a lot, that means that the two-bar man is on one side. And the idea here is simply just to shoot around the two-bar man. Because many players are having some issues with covering specifically the correct corner with the two-bar man, because you don't have really a row if you take the man who is like freestanding, right? So you can take use of it with focusing on this man. And now maybe you are wondering how you can focus on the two-bar man, shooting around the two-bar man while you are looking in a peripheral way, right? The indirect way. But this is also possible. Even if you focus on the ball and see the other stuff peripheral, you can still focus a specific area or a specific man. So you will follow in a peripheral way, you will follow the two-bar man. Example number two. This is simply just focus on one half of the goal or even a specific corner. That means in both ways, either if you're looking in an indirect way or in a direct way, you can focus on one half of the goal. If you do so, you will recognize that you can execute a shot very good when no puppet is there anymore. Another advantage of this is also you can see the short corner pretty good and also maybe the straight hole. Still, it could be sometimes a little bit difficult by recognizing when your opponent is really leaving the other side open because you're so focused on one half of the goal. Now it's a question, how can I practice it? it's kind of difficult to practice it alone at the table. So you need to practice it either with a partner, with a sparring partner, or you are practicing it during a training match. It's actually really simple to experience it, to try it out, to, like, you know, go to the match and say, okay, I will try to do the indirect way and I will focus on the two-bar man, for example. But many players are like going into it and then they forget it after three or four balls, so there's no chance that you really practice it. So if you're able to do what you say to yourself before the match and you do it in the match, then it's a perfect practice, right? Because if you're not trying it out, it will be kind of difficult to widen your horizon in reading and discovering, like, how can you look at the defense. These were my tips about how to read football defenses, and if you liked my video, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button. Thanks for watching and joining with me the Strategy Sunday episode. See you soon, FooXs. I cannot wait for another journey with you.